Fiat presented the revolutionary TwinAir engine back in 2008 and started using it in cars in 2010. It has been used in the Fiat 500, Fiat 500L, Punto, Panda, and also in the Lancia and Alfa Romeo entry-level hatchbacks. The TwinAir family is mostly known thanks to the 0.9 turbo engine, which is a two-cylinder engine. It comes with the cast iron block, chain-driven timing system, and also it's equipped with the Mitsubishi turbocharger. There have been several types of engines that offered 85 to 105 horsepower and 145 newton meters of torque. Actually, the engine itself is not that bad, and I don't see a lot of complaints in forums, but still, it will have certain common faults. First of all, the chain is not going to last forever. The bad thing is to replace the chain kit at 60,000 miles or 90,000 kilometers before it fails. Fortunately, the chain kits are not that expensive and are not really hard to replace, so it won't cost you a fortune. Also, the complicated valve system in these machines includes the UniAir module with very tricky oil passages and actuators that are controlled by the ECU. The idea is that the engine may quickly change phases of valves opening and closing using oil actuators that work under quite high pressure. But this leads to issues with these actuators, and once something fails in the UniAir system, the entire module will have to be replaced since it's almost impossible to repair. The unit itself costs over 1000 euros plus labor to install it, so it's not that cheap. It's expected to last 150 to 200,000 kilometers, but it may fail earlier if you experiment with oil viscosity or don't change oil for a long time. It's commonly believed that these engines have problems with turbochargers, but they wouldn't say the issues are very common. Yes, again, if you use bad oil and never change it, the Mitsubishi turbocharger will fail sooner or later, but with proper maintenance, these turbos last forever. Also, there are aftermarket and refurbished options you can go for, and they are not that bad unless they are sold at a suspiciously low price. A lot of experts claim that the variable oil pump and the electronic thermostat are very expensive and potentially unreliable, but I haven't heard about any cases of them failing, so I don't consider this a common fault. Overall, these engines are made for quite light cars like the Fiat 500, and they offer pretty good torque, so they won't feel underpowered, but in the Fiat 500L, which is not a tiny vehicle, you will obviously feel some lack of power. Also, I would expect this engine to last about 180-200,000 kilometers or up to 120,000 miles, but after that it's a bit of a lottery since a lot of quite expensive units may fail almost at once and take a ton of money out of your pocket. But if you use good oil, change it frequently, and also replace the timing chain kit once every 60,000 miles, I believe you can easily use this engine much longer than that.